On your favorite show, the Heena Bhimani Wellness Show. And today we will be discussing about yoga poses to help reduce back pain. Now, back pain has become very common in all of us, like right from a small child to a teenager to a grown-up adult to an elderly person. Everybody has back pain. And the cause of back pain is... just a second. The cause of back pain is because of the lifestyle, the way we sit, our posture, and all of that matters. If our posture is not right, you know, if you're not doing something to strengthen your back, the back will always pain. So you have to make sure that, you know, you keep moving your back, you keep strengthening your back so that, you know, your back stays strong. And back is a very important part of your body. The entire nervous system, okay, your entire nervous system passes through your spine. The signal going through to your brain, to your, you know, eyes. The signal going through your brain, to your eyes, to your, you know, legs. Everywhere in the body goes through your back. So back is extremely important. If you don't have a back, you will not be able to sit properly. So back is very important. And whatever form of workout you do in your life, you do gymming, you do yoga, you do swimming, you do dancing, whatever you do, walking, you have to always make sure that you focus on strengthening your back and not just, you know, doing the basic exercises. Strengthening your back is extremely important. And if you do walking or if you do Zumba, you're not doing any exercise specifically to strengthen your back. In swimming, you are strengthening your back because when you're doing the back strokes, when you're doing the butterfly strokes, there you're using your back. So swimming is actually very good for strengthening your back. Yoga is amazing for strengthening your back. Gym workout along with some of the yoga poses are great for the back. So whatever workout you do, whatever form of workout you choose, you have to add some exercises, which I'm going to show you today, which will not take you more than, you know, if you have 10 minutes and not less than, you know, not more than that. If you have more time, you can, you know, focus more on your back exercises. Very, very important. So I see a lot of people over here. Thank you, Malik Arjun. Good morning. Zulfi's here. Good morning. This year's last weekend show. Yes. Oh, yes. This is the last weekend show. And the 2020 year is back. And we're just waiting for 2020 and, you know, excited about 2020. Sonia is here. Hi, Sonia. Thank you so much for tuning in. Good morning. Where have you been? Where have you disappeared? I'm not seeing you at all. Where are you? 2 p.m. Yes, Vignesh, don't forget to come today at 2 p.m. also. So you will see me at 2 p.m. also. Thand, Sonia, it's not as bad. Like, Mumbai ki thand matlab garmi ke barabar hi hai. We haven't even, you know, the skin is feeling dry. Mornings are a little cooler, but it is not. I have kept the fan on and we don't even need the, you know, fan on hi rakhna padta hai because it's actually not so cool. Thank you, Tejas Sai. Thank you for tuning in. Tejas, I will have to block you if I see one more word like that because these kind of words, this kind of language is not allowed. So first and last warning to you. So please mind your language or I will have to block you right away. Kumar Gaurav, good morning. Malik K, hi, hi. Thank you so much for tuning in. So now I'm going to teach you some exercises which you can sit and do it. Okay, so some sitting exercises which are great for your back. So follow me, do along with me, and if you have any questions for me, please feel free to ask me. And I have already 1,000 hearts. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for those beautiful hearts. So keep sending those beautiful hearts and keep motivating me. Gautam Bittu, namaste. Thank you. Sonia saying, here 1.7. Kahan? Where is this? Are you talking about Delhi? Is it so cold? Tejas, you are blocked forever. Okay, so now I'm going to be doing the exercise which you can do sitting. Now, I have taught you how to do cat pose, okay? So this is sitting cat pose and cat stretch, which is great for your back. So wherever you're sitting, you can do these exercises, okay? So keep your back straight, grab your knees, okay? Breathing in, look up. Chest up, move your chest up, push your lower back forward. Breathing out, round your back. touch your chin to your chest. Inhale, push your lower back forward, chest forward, shoulders back, drop your head at the back. Breathing out round your back, touch your chin to your chest. Inhale, shoulders back, chest up, look up. Exhale, round your back. So this is a great exercise for your entire spine. So it is a great way to warm up your spine. Now I'm going to show you stretches to warm up your upper back. A lot of time we have pain in our upper back, so these exercises will help you to release the pressure from your upper back and feel good. Okay, stress and pressure from your upper back. So interlace your fingers. If you see my back, okay, just see how my back is going. Inhale, round your upper back. Okay, I'm rounding my upper back. I'm stretching my hands forward like this. I'll show you from both the angles so that you come to know how it is supposed to be done. Inhale, exhale, round your back, stretch your hands forward and push your hands away from your body. Exhale, come back, breathe in, breathing out, stretch your fingers out and round your upper back. Feels amazing. Inhale, come back, exhale again, round your upper back, come back, exhale, stretch your fingers out and come back. This is a great exercise for your upper back. Then what I showed was the sitting cat pose, cat stretch, very good for your entire spine. Now sitting, you can do some of the stretches, basic stretches, which are great for your back. Now a side bend. So you will lift your one hand up, one hand will be on the floor, okay, the other hand up, and bend without twisting your body. So you have to make sure that both your shoulders are in one line and your back is all rounded, so you're not doing this. To keep your back straight, and you have to bend like this. Very, very good for toning your sides. So if you have flab over here, it will help you to tone the flab. At the same time, this is great for your paraspinal muscles. Now when I say paraspinal muscles, the muscles which are around your spine, these muscles are also very important for your back, okay? So it helps in stretching and strengthening your paraspinal muscles, which hold your spine. So these muscles will hold your spine, which will help you to keep your spine strong and prevent the backache. The other one is, keep your hand down, bend. I think I'm going to move at the back so you guys can see me. Stretch and bend. Feel a nice stretch, the entire stretch on the side right till your hand. And down. And stretch. And down. This feels great. This feels great. Your side stretches, your spine stretches. So very good stretch for your back pain. Tarun is here. Hi Tarun, good morning. Any exercise to make the back straight? Yes, I'm going to be showing you some exercises to make your back straight also. So you want to correct your spine, do the stretches that I showed you, and Ulta Namaste, Paschim Namaskar is very good for people who have rounded upper back. To improve this, you do this. Take one hand at the back, then you take the other hand at the back and you join your hands like this in Namaste. And keep moving your elbows and shoulders back. Keep your head up, head, shoulders going back, and hold. This is great for people who have rounded upper back. This will help you to improve your posture. This is great for your stiffness in the shoulder, your elbows, your wrist joint. This will really help you to mobilize it and improve the flexibility. Okay, so one hand up, the other hand up, join your palm, elbows and shoulders back, push your hips forward, chest forward, and hold. So this is good for improving your posture. So this you can do even standing, okay? This Paschim Namaskar can be done standing also. Very, very good for your back. Can you show some stretches for pain in lumbar region? So guys, lumbar, so this is your cervical region. This is your thoracic region and this is your lumbar region. So for long, how long it has to be done. So paschim namaskar, you have to hold at least for 5 deep breaths. So you have to keep breathing. So say, for example, I have joined my hands. Okay, I will breathe in. Breathing out, I will move my elbows back. Again, I will breathe in. Breathing out, I will move my elbows back. So I will do this for 5 deep breaths and release and repeat it 3 times. Amazing. This is very good for our wrist, elbow, shoulder joints. So future mein shoulder pain, tennis elbow ya wrist pain nahi hoga, because we use our laptops, we use our phones so much, and nowadays we don't have a practice of writing. And that makes it even more stiff because we don't write, okay? We don't cook. So especially ladies who, you know, jo aata banti hai, they have good flexible wrist joint. But nowadays we don't do all that work. We have, you know, house help. We have cooks for us to do the thing. So then this becomes very stiff and then it causes a lot of pain and discomfort. I have so many people who have excruciating pain in these joints, and I can't tell you how, you know, bad it is, and then how much they struggle to get rid of the pain. Okay, so these exercises will improve the mobility of the joints. See, mobility, shoulder ki mobility, ye sab improve hogi. So do it regularly. Ulta Namaste, like what I showed, is something that you can do any time of the day. You don't have to be empty stomach to do this, because your tummy is not involved, right? You're not involving your tummy. So while you're walking, while you're watching TV, while you're doing some work, whenever you remember, okay, chalo, kar lete hai. So that way, try to do 2 to 3 times in a day. And if you cannot do Ulta Namaste, you can even hold your elbows at the back. Now this is great for your upper back, so should be done every day. Can you show from the back? Yes, I will be showing you from the back. Okay. So one hand goes up. Okay. I'm folding my hand and I'm moving my hand up. Then I'm taking the other hand. Okay. Keep moving this at the back. Now you can even do this way. You can join your palms down like this. Okay. And then turn. So here, move it slightly away from your body, turn it and go up like this. Now try to hold your elbows. Now if you can't do Ulta Namaste, you can try and hold your elbows like this. Hold your elbows and keep lifting it upwards. Okay, so a lot of variations. You can try whichever one is comfortable for you. Gagan Ranja, hi, good morning. Thank you for tuning in. Vishal Kadgaonkar, namaste. Ishan Ansari, good morning. Thank you everyone for tuning in. You're welcome, Zulfi. Shaurika, good morning. So, what we learned is how to do Ulta Namaste different ways, and you can simply hold your elbows, which is great for your back. I just tried it. It's very difficult to start in doing it directly. What should be the first step, Hina? Yeah, it's very difficult to start it because, you know, it's the years of stiffness that, you know, causes this problem, okay? Apne saalo saal kabhi ye exercise nahi ki. So it will be very stiff. So it's, you know, you can start holding your elbows at the back, you know, try to hold your elbows at the back and keep lifting it upwards, which will open this part of your shoulder, okay? Then you can try and take one hand at the back, okay? Then try and take the other hand at the back. So slowly you will have to practice this regularly. Regular practice se jo hai ye definitely hoga. Gagan Ranjay saying, could you help in solving my foot drop problem? One leg muscle gone weak. Okay. So if your one leg muscle has gone weak, you will have to focus on. So the foot drop happens if the muscle cannot hold the foot properly, and that's how the foot drops. Okay. So the muscle around your foot, okay, which is your calf muscle, your calf muscle is more important, okay? So your calf muscle strong hona chahiye. Also thigh muscle has to be strong so that your muscle can hold the foot joint properly. Now for that, you'll have to start doing the exercises which will strengthen your leg muscles. Now your leg muscles will strengthen if you do squats, if you squat and hold. So a wall squat is great for strengthening your entire leg, okay? I'm not making you do a direct squat, a free squat, because that may put too much pressure on your joints. So a wall squat is great for your foot drop problem. Okay, I'm going to show you how to do it. So you go against the wall. Okay, you go against the wall. You walk a few steps forward and then you squat. Okay, the gap between your legs will be your hip distance. So your knee will fall exactly over your heel. Place your palms at the back. Keep pressing your palms on the wall and hold this. Make sure your lower back is on the wall. Hold this for three counts. 1, 1,002, 1,003. Then slowly come back and relax. Amazing for your knees, but if you have knee pain, you will have to be careful. People with knee pain can do wall squat, but don't hold it for too long. So 2 to 3 counts are fine. Okay, you shouldn't feel any pressure on your knees while you're doing this. Okay, so squat, make sure your lower back is touching the wall. Roll your shoulders back, place your palms on the wall. Okay, and feel your thighs. You'll start feeling the muscles of your thighs and your calves. Hold for 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, and slowly come back and release. So this is great for your thighs. Okay, great for your thighs and great for foot drop, and also do the foot rotation and all the yoga asanas like Warrior 1, Warrior 2, Warrior 3. All these asanas are great for strengthening your leg muscles because you're lunging, you're holding the posture. So Warrior 1, Warrior 2, Warrior 3 must be done regularly. Vishal is saying some exercises for my hand, wrist, hand. For your hand, I showed you this one. Then you can do the wrist rotation, this one clockwise, anti-clockwise. Then stretch. Okay, keep your palms straight, stretch it. All the fingers at the back. This hand will go down like this. And then you will pull it at the back. Okay, this will stretch this portion, which becomes very stiff. So you can, yes, start practicing this. इससे जो है इसमें flexibility बढ़ेगी, wrist joint में flexibility बढ़ेगी. So this, turn your palm this, then the other hand, this, turn your palm this, and wrist rotation. Okay. Also spread your fingers as wide as you can, and then make a fist. Spread your fingers as wide as you can, and make a fist. Spread your fingers. Make a fist. Spread your fingers. Make a fist. Spread your fingers. Make a fist. So this is great for your wrist joint. Cervical pain, cervical and neck pain region. Okay. Cervical and neck pain region. So if you have cervical pain, I'm going to show you a very good exercise which will help you to strengthen your cervical. So place your palm on your forehead. Push your head forward. Resist and hold. Hold for 5 counts. 1. So when I say resist, okay, what I mean is I'm pushing my head against my hand, and at the same time I'm pushing my hand at the back. So dono taraf se main pressure de rahi hu, okay, without moving my head forward. I'm trying to stop my head from going forward with the help of my hand. So 1, I will feel that contraction on my neck. 2, 3, 4, 5. Same hand on the side. Push your head on the side, resist. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Switch, resist. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Chin down, elbows up, resist. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Push your head at the back, elbows forward, resist. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. So very good for cervical pain. This will help in releasing the cervical pain. And slowly drop your ear to your shoulder. Come back to the other side. Come back to the other side. Come back and switch. Come back and twist. Come back and twist. And make a semicircle slowly. Left to your right shoulder. without dropping your head completely at the back. Listen to your body. See how much your body allows you to do. And switch. Go to your shoulder. And switch. And switch. Switch. Then, have semicircle down. Left, right. Very good for your neck region. Gagan is saying may fall due to weak support of leg. No, you will not fall. That's why I made you do a wall squat. So you have support of the wall. So you will not fall. So you can hold for, you know, 1001, 1002, two counts, release. Keep doing it, because if you don't do at all, your thigh legs will not become strong. So you will have to start somewhere. Don't hold it for too long, okay? Amit Pawar, Namaste Ji, good morning. Aap abhi, aaj bhi online. I thought you will be enjoying last Sunday of the year. Yaar, har Sunday enjoy karti hu. When I do my sessions with you all, I'm enjoying it so much that I don't have to wait to take a holiday. I actually look forward to coming and doing my sessions with you all, because I just love it. It has become a part of my life, and I really feel incomplete without coming and, you know, saying my highs and hellos to you all. So thank you so much. Really appreciate you all coming on the last Sunday of the month and watching me. Thank you so much. 1.6k people watching me live. I love you all. Thank you. Thank you so much. That shows how much serious you are about your own health, and you know, you all want to be fit despite being a Sunday. You don't want to sleep, but you want to come and watch a yoga session, which is amazing. So guys, keep doing, keep coming and keep liking my session. And keep motivating me. My hearts have also gone up. I remember this was the exact punishment I used to get almost every day for incomplete homework. Hell of pain it was. Which punishment? Wall squat punishment? Which punishment are you saying? Soma Shankar Acharya is saying, please show a six-pack exercise. Okay. Sabse pehle to six-pack jo hai na. एक्सरसाइज तब भी होगी जब भी आपकी लाइफ में डिसिप्लिन होगा. सिर्फ एक्सरसाइज से नहीं होगा. सो यू हैव टू ईट वेल, यू हैव टू स्लीप वेल, सो दैट योर बॉडी यू नो रिकवर्स एंड हील्स फास्टर. यू विल हैव टू यू नो हैव सफिशिएंट वाटर. यू हैव टू कीप योरसेल्फ एक्टिव सो दैट योर बॉडी यू नो इफ यू स्लीप योर बॉडी गेट्स टाइम टू रिकवर. अ लॉट ऑफ दीज फैक्टर्स विल हेल्प, बट ऑफ कोर्स फ्यू एक्सरसाइजेस लाइक प्लैंक्स, क्रंचेस, वॉकिंग, Naukasan are great for getting those six-pack abs. I have a lot of questions. I'm going to get answer these questions, and I have to show you all some exercises for the back. Deepak is saying, wrist pain seems ligament after lifting heavy weight tire. Using wristband and hot and cold wrapping for recovery. Are there any exercises as well for quick recovery, or should I give complete rest to the wrist? Deepak, give complete rest to the wrist. Oh, okay, if you feel it's a ligament tear, then you should give complete rest to the wrist and stop using those wristbands for now, and you know, do the basic exercises like these stretches. And if you feel pain or discomfort, just move it slowly. You will have to check with your physio or your doctor to understand the severity of the tear or pain. I don't know, because I don't know how much mobility you have, how much pain you have, but these were the exercises which are good. I would suggest that, you know, take professional help once and check if, you know, these exercises are okay to do. A lot of times, you know, some you need to rest your muscle, then move it so that it recovers faster. If you keep moving, it will not recover faster and the pain will keep reoccurring, which you don't want to happen. So please check with the professional once. Rahul Mali is here. Hi Rahul. Krishnan, most welcome. Thanks for quickly addressing my issue. Could you give me a demo on Warrior 1, 2, 3? Yes, I'm going to give you a demo on Warrior 1, 2 and 3. Dhruv, I'm going to be giving you exercises for the back pain. Very good exercises. Please do it. I love these exercises and I can't tell you how much it helps. I always had perpetual back pain, and from the time I've started yoga, I mean, I feel amazing in my back. I can lift heavy weight and I can walk for long. So for lifting, you know, something in your hand, like, you know, even if you do, you know, you go to shopping and you have to lift heavy bags and walk. If you have back issue, you cannot walk with heavy weights. But if you have strong back, you can lift heavy bags and you can walk because your back is strong. You can lift heavy things from the top. You can do your household work easily. You can pull your own bag because your back is strong. So back is important. So I couldn't do all those things because I had weak back and I had a very bad shape. I had shape like this. My back was rounded like this. So now with yoga, my posture has improved and my back has become so strong. I can lift my own bag weight. I can carry someone, like I can carry a baby and I can walk for long. You know, I can carry a heavy baby and walk for long. That's because the back is strong. So I'm definitely going to show you all the exercises for the back. Thank you so much, Charika. Thank you so much. Krishna is saying, this year 2019, the most memorable exercise I remember was aerial yoga you did with another coach. Yes, yes, that was a great exercise. And guys, for the new year, next weekend, there is a surprise for you all. And that I'm going to be doing, so I'm going to spill the beans. And the surprise is that I know a lot of you all have enjoyed the aerial yoga session. So that session is going to happen next Sunday. So be prepared to see some amazing moves with Ketan sir. Hi, can you suggest some easy stretching exercise during office work? Yes, yes, yes. My foot fingers not squeezing and squeezing out. Okay, three easy stretching exercise, powerful ones. Okay, Vishal, three easy. So first I'm going to, since the topic is about the back and I have two, three questions for the back, I'm going to show you the back exercises, which are the top three exercises and powerful ones for the back. I'm going to show you that, and after that I will address the other questions. Okay, now I'm going to lie down on my back. Okay, this exercise is very good for the back. Turn to one side, take the support of your hand, and then you lie down on your back. Keep your knees bent. Okay, keep your knees bent. Place your palms on the floor. If you guys cannot see me properly, move this at the back. Now I think you will be able to see me. Okay, so you lie down on the back, bend your knees, keep comfortable distance between your legs, place your hands on the wall, breathing in, lift your lower back, turn your shoulder inwards, grab your ankles and stay there. Keep lifting your lower back and hold. This is amazing for your back. Hold for 5 counts and release. Okay, Setu Bandhasan hip bridge pose. Very, very good for strengthening your back. Okay, it also helps in toning your back and your butt. Okay, so keep your palms on the floor, or you can even grab your ankles, whatever is comfortable. Breathing in, lift your lower back. Keep lifting your lower back. Squeeze your glutes. Turn your shoulders inwards. Breathing out, slowly release. After this, you will do a knee hug. The knee hug is also very good for your back. Okay, try to pull your knee towards your chest, lift your head, try to touch your head to your knees. Very good for your back. Okay, now the next exercise is Setu Bandha, Bhujangasana. Bhujangasana is great for your back. So I'm going to lie down on my stomach. Okay, I'm going to do it this way so that you guys can watch me properly. So there is comfortable distance between my legs. I'm placing my palms. I think you can see me now. Under my shoulders. Breathing in, I'm coming halfway up. Just this much up. I'm not doing this. I'm keeping my shoulders down and I'm keeping my head at the back. Amazing, a very powerful exercise for the back. And so I'm lifting my body only till my belly button and not beyond that. So lift only till your belly button. Don't do this. Okay, don't do Purna Bhujangasana. do Ardha Bhujangasana, half Bhujangasana, and I will also show you Salamba Bhujangasana, easy Bhujangasana for people who can't even do Ardha Bhujangasana. Ardha means half Bhujangasana. So palms under your shoulders, comfortable distance between your legs. Breathing in, come halfway up. This is Ardha Bhujangasana, just in my belly button. Breathe out and up. This is Ardha Bhujangasana. Salambha Bhujangasana is this. You are on your elbows, okay? Hands are like this and my shoulders are back. This is Salambha Bhujangasana. I have kept comfortable distance between my legs. You can even keep your legs together. Or you can keep comfortable distance between your legs. Salambha, simple Bhujangasana, okay? The next one is Salabhasana, which is very good for your back. Okay, so you lie down on your stomach. Place your palms under your thighs. The chin is on the floor. You're breathing in. Lift your right leg up. Just your right leg up. Hold for 5 counts. Drop your leg down. Then lift your left leg up. Hold for 5 counts. Then lift both the legs together up. And then drop it down. Both the legs together up and drop it down. So each posture you will hold for 5 counts. Right leg up for 5 counts, left leg up for 5 counts, both the legs together up for 5 counts. And you will repeat this entire set 3 rounds. Amazing for the back. Ardha Bhujangasana or Salambha Bhujangasana, Salabhasana, Setu Bandhasana, amazing for your back. Okay. And knee hug, very good for your back. Vakrasana, amazing for your back. So you lie down on your back. For Vakrasana, you have to lie down on your back. Take the support of your hands. Lie down on your back. Keep your knees bent. Keep your knees bent. Place your hands at shoulder level. Drop your knees to one side. Knees together, feet together. Knee over your knee. Turn your head to the opposite side. Come back in the center. Go to the other side. Drop your knees to the other side. Knee over your knee. Push your lower back forward. Come back in the center. Again, drop your knees to one side. Turn your head to the opposite side. Come back in the center. Drop your knees to the other side. And relax. Okay, turn to one side and sit up. So what I showed you was Vakrasana. So Vakrasana is great for your back. Okay, Bhujangasana, Ardha Bhujangasana, Salambha Bhujangasana, Setu Bandhasana, knee hug, amazing for your back. So you must do these asanas regularly if you want to strengthen your back and get rid of the pain from the back. Thank you, Ritesh. Thank you all will watch. Yes, please watch and please practice these exercises. Amazing for strengthening your back. Aerial aerobics yoga, Matrix 2, Matrix Reloaded movie. So we'll sit in front of mobile with chips, kurkure, tea. Yes, you are going to have fun next Sunday, guys. Do not forget to come and watch me live next Sunday. And mostly we are going to do on the beach. So you will have fun. बीच पे हम करने वाले हैं तो बीच की लहरों के बीच आप देखोगे ये सारे आसन्स. यू विल हैव फन. प्लीज डू नॉट मिस नेक्स्ट संडे एट 9:30 माय योगा सेशन. सो या वॉरियर 1, वॉरियर 2 एंड वॉरियर 3 आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू गगन फॉर योर फुट ड्रॉप. ओके, सो स्टे ट्यून. सो वॉरियर 1, सो यू विल कीप अ गैप ऑफ 3.5 to 4 feet बिटवीन योर लेग्स. Okay, your heels, both the heels will be in one line. Keep your back foot slightly turned inwards. Keep your hands at shoulder level. Keep your hips in the center. Breathe in. Breathing out, bend your knee. Okay, bend your knee so that your knee comes over your ankle. If you feel the distance is too low, you should feel a nice stretch. But your knee will never exceed your toes. Okay, feel a nice stretch. Keep your arms at shoulder level and look at your front hand like this. This is great for your strengthening your legs and great for your foot drop. Same thing you will repeat on the other side. Point your toes, lower your hips, knee over your ankle, hands at shoulder level, gaze on your front hand. That's warrior 1. Warrior 2 is you will square your hips, okay, join your palms and hold. Keep looking at your thumb, okay, drop your head at the back. Now I'll show you my back foot. My back foot is slightly turned inwards, okay, my heel is flat, I'm not lifting my heel. My heel is flat and I'm doing this, okay, this is warrior 2. Same thing on the other side, square your hips, back foot flat, knee over your ankle, drop, join your hands and hold. So this is warrior 1, warrior 2. Warrior 3 is where you balance, okay. So join your hands, both the hands up, lift your left leg up, drop it, and at the same time lift your right leg up, balance. If you can't balance, you will hold on to something. So I'm holding on to a table. And come back. Step back. Inhale, join your hands. Lift the other leg up, drop it. And hold to a table. Balance. And release. Each posture you will hold for 3 to 5 counts. Okay? This will really help you with your foot drop problem because this will strengthen your leg. लेग स्ट्रेंथनिंग के लिए बहुत ही अच्छी एक्सरसाइज है, तू जरूर से करे. समांता, दीज आर अमेजिंग फॉर द बैक पेन, फॉर लंबर पेन. सो वॉट एवर एक्सरसाइज आई शोड यू इज गुड फॉर योर एंटायर स्पाइन, बट भुजंगासन, सलभासन, वॉट ऑल आसन आई शोड यू इज ग्रेट एंड अमेजिंग फॉर योर लंबर पेन एंड इट विल गिव यू अमेजिंग रिजल्ट. सो प्लीज प्रैक्टिस इट. So guys, it's time for me to go. I'm going to go for now and I'm hoping to see you all again at 2 o'clock. So keep smiling, take very good care of yourself. And if you haven't subscribed to my session yet, please go ahead and subscribe to my session. Keep smiling.